What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over the Shopkeepers plugin in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Creating a shop on a server comes with more difficulty than just creating the shop itself. If you don't have some kind of security system, you're left hoping that someone doesn't come along and steal all of the items in your shop. Plugins like Shopkeepers are a good way to solve problems like these. With Shopkeepers, you are able to create custom NPC shops to securely sell your goods. Let's go over how to install and use the Shopkeepers plugin. Head to the Shopkeepers spigot page and in the top right, press the blue download button. Make sure to save the file to a safe location for later. Next, head to the Apex server panel and stop the server, and scroll down to the game file section and make sure that the version is plugin compatible, like paper or spigot, and that the game version matches the plugin that you downloaded. Afterwards, enter the FTP file access in the left-hand menu and log in. Find or create the plugins folder and then enter it, and on the next page, press upload in the top left menu, and then drag and drop the jar files. Once they are 100% uploaded, return to the main panel page and restart the server. Player shops are the default shop used by the plugin. Players can create a shop through commands or by using the Shopkeeper egg item. We recommend using the egg since it comes with instructions that will appear in the chat when a player holds it in their hand. They will need to run the command shopkeeper give to gain a shopkeeper egg or to purchase one from an admin shop if your server has one. Place a chest or another container. This is where your items will be stored. Without looking at any blocks, right-click while holding the shopkeeper egg. This will set what kind of shop you want to use and give a description of each type of shop. With the egg still in your hand, right-click on the container that you want the shopkeeper to use. This container will be protected by the plugin so no other players can break or alter it. Hold the shift key, then right-click with the egg to choose what kind of NPC you want the shopkeeper to be. Aim at the block that you want the shopkeeper to stand on, and then right-click on it with the egg to create the shopkeeper. Finally, add the items you want to buy or sell to your shopkeeper's chest, and then right-click on the shopkeeper while holding shift to set the prices. Depending on what NPC you chose, you might have other options available to customize the shop. These options let you set different variants like a villager's profession or a cat's color. These options will be displayed as blocks at the bottom of the Shopkeeper editor. Admin shops are easier to make than a player shop. You will only need to run a command to create the shop and then configure it with the items that you want to sell. Unlike player shops, admin shops have infinite items, so you don't need a storage chest to create one. You can also manually set the currency item in admin shops instead of using a default currency in the config file. Look at the block where you want the shopkeeper to stand, and then run the command shopkeeper, and then the creature that you want to use as your NPC. Hold down shift, and then right-click on the shopkeeper to edit. Place the items you want to sell on the top line of boxes in the menu, and then place the items that you want to use as currency in the second line. Once the items have been placed, you're done. We recommend creating an admin shop like this to sell shopkeeper eggs, since it will make it easier for players to create their own shops without having to use commands. By default, the Shopkeepers plugins use emeralds and emerald blocks as currency for the plugin. This can be changed to different items in the plugin's configuration files. Head to your control panel and click on the Config Files tab in the menu on the left side, and then find the config YML file for Shopkeepers on the list. The description will have Shopkeepers inside of it. Click on the file to open it in our web editor, and then scroll down to the bottom of the page to find the Currency Item option. You can change the currency in any way that you like. This will allow you to use any block from the game or change the value of the currency. Once you've completed your changes, click on the green Save button at the top of the page and restart the server. With that, you are ready to start creating your own shopkeepers on your Minecraft server. Adding shopkeepers to your server is a great way for your players to create their own automated shops while also keeping all of the shops safe from players looking to steal items. You can watch your server's economy grow as players become more involved with their own little shops. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.